I've known you for many years, Tony. You are naturally a positive, you know, effulgent, wonderful, sunshiny kind of person. There are others who may not, that may not come so easily to them. So you mentioned something already. You try to get a diary and then write things down. That helps a little bit too. And I just wanted to say another quick point. You lost both your parents. It just occurred to me now. You lost both your parents to cancer.
Yes.
And there are many people who have lost people with cancer, who have had people, they've lost people to cancer in their families, that image is so strong in their minds about what their parents went through, that it seems to overpower whatever kind of positive thoughts they're trying to create in their minds. So what would you say to help such people?
Let's learn what we can from our parents' mistakes without holding those mistakes against them. I've learned all kinds of things from my mom's life and my dad's that I can do differently. And so I'm not expecting the same results my parents had. You know, okay.
We don't have to be
locked into what's happened to our parents. We can rise above that.
Right. So what I would say to people, I mean, I say this a lot too, is that once those thoughts start coming, don't let them park, I like that word. Don't let that thing park in their minds. And I usually say you have to vocalize, say things like, I reject it. I'm going to stay healthy. And maybe say how long you're going to live. Nothing less than 80, of course, because at 80, to me, that's the basic minimum any human being should be living for in this 21st century. Yeah. So that's what I say. I mean, you can accept anything after 80, nothing before 80. And I feel people need to vocalize a lot more than just keeping
quiet. Because your body lines up with that.
Exactly.
Your body lines up with what you tell it and believe. And so I decided with where my kids are that within 25 years, we will probably have all our grandkids born. We'll be having great grandkids, but all our grandkids should be born in the next 25. So I just told David, he was in the hospital and I was diagnosed. I said, we both have to live 25 more years. Both of us.
85, yeah, then, right?
Exactly. Because I don't want to live without him. He don't want to live without me. And I said, then that's our bottom line. We're living 25 years and that's what we're telling our bodies we have to do.
And fantastic.
So, you know, my body just follows along what I tell it. I mean,
absolutely.
It's bizarre.
I think that's a great example. And I hope people are listening to this. You've got to vocalize these things. If you don't say it, and we now know that science is catching up, and it's like they find out that your immune system actually listens. Obviously, every cell in your body listens to it, to what your words say. But I think your immune system and your brain, more than any other cell in the body, they listen and they respond to what you're saying. And of course, it always helps if you say things with a lot of feeling, a lot of passion. And that helps to lock it in a lot more. So please make it a point, especially if you're going through a very tough warfare, especially with something like cancer or something else like this. Don't be quiet. You got to speak up. You got to say things. And if you're looking for words to get from whatever scriptures or whatever holy books you want to read from, there are always positive things you can get those things out from. I think. What do you think about that? Where can I get positive?
You know, do you remember the test? Most people are familiar with it. Of the scientist, I believe he was Asian, who did the test with the water. And he
Japanese guy. Yeah.
You know, our bodies are 70% something water.
Right.
That test revealed so much about how our bodies respond to words.
Right.
Because we are mostly water, and he spoke for 1 month, good things, bad things, and then what's the word I want? No things. There were the third one, he just neglected.
Okay.
And so it's not even a matter of you just don't talk about the bad. It's you have to be intentional and make choices and tell your body and your family what you're going to do, what you want, what you're expecting out of this life and how this is going to go. And have your
family tell you the same thing. Get them to start saying the same things. But that helps too, right? If you have support from your
people. Ask me all the time, how are your kids doing with this? Well, every one of them have been raised the way I feel and think and believe. And they all just believe with me, every one of them, even after watching my mother go through it horrifically for 5 years, every one of them just believe we're going to be okay. David and I both, we're both going to come through all this stronger. And you know, the truth is, if I die tomorrow, I'm okay with that. I'm ready to die. It's not like I'm in denial. You know, any of us can go any day. So let's make the most of every day that we have. So I just decide every day I'm going to do what I want to do, and I'm going to love the people in my life, and I'm going to enjoy my life. And whenever I go, it's going to be okay. But I believe I'm going to be here another 25 years.